The Lord bless you. We thank His holy name for granting us the privilege to see another wonderful, wonderful day so that we can nourish one another in our daily nourishment for leaders and ministers of the gospel and mature Christians. Today, our topic is effective ways to preach for growth. Effective ways to preach for growth. And the Bible passage is Psalm 68, verse number 11. That's the first one. The second one is going to be 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 18 to 21. The Lord gave the word. Great was the company of those that published it, that proclaim it, that preach it, that minister it. The Lord gave the word. Great was the company of those that proclaim it and publish it. The second one is, for the preaching of the cross is to them that perish foolishness, but unto us which are saved, it is the power of God. For after that, in the wisdom of God, the world by wisdom knew not God, it pleased God by the foolishness of preaching to save them that believe. It pleased God by the foolishness of preaching to save them that believe. This is our thought today. This is our nourishment today. The place of preaching in the growth of the church, very, very fundamental. The place of the pulpit, because that is the will of God, is the one who designed it. By somebody either sitting or standing up, opening his mouth, preaching the gospel, that's the way he has chosen to talk to us and touch us and bring them to repentance in our Lord Jesus Christ. It's the design of God. Today, we have videos, we have slides, we have charts, we have all that, but it can never replace preaching. It can never replace preaching. And over the years, I've discovered and I've done the research, either in my own personal experience and in ministry and in other churches, I've discovered that if the preaching is poor, the church will not really grow. If the preaching is weak, if the preaching is not excellent, it's not superb, it's not communicated in a very dynamic way, the church will not grow. Today, a lot of people come to church, they come to our services, they come to our worship services. What are they coming for? They want to listen to sound words, sound preaching. And when the preacher, the pastor, the leader has not developed him or herself to be a good communicator, a good preacher of the word of God, it will affect the lives of the people. Shepherds must be good shepherds by preaching the word. Because if you read Jeremiah 3:15, he says, I will give you pastors after my heart, which are feed you. Shepherds are to feed the sheep. And how do you feed them? With the word, with the counseling, with the advice, with the preaching, with the communication of the word in a sound, logical, effective, relevant, dynamic, transparent, and impactful ways. So as a preacher, when we don't develop the grace and the ability to preach well, to preach in a transforming way, preaching that touches the heart, not the one that tickles the ear or tickles the brain, preaching that really touch people's heart, the church will not grow. I've seen a lot of churches that people go away and they get disappointed because the preaching was not good. So you can't just rise up today and say, I want my church to grow. Preaching nonsense. People will not listen because today people have options. People can go to the internet and watch preaching. People tune to so many internet to get preaching. So as a preacher, it's important. And we must recognize the place of preaching in the growth of the church. The Lord gave the word. Great is the company of those that publish it. Preachers, Christian believers, we are meant to publish. Any platform, either in the office, in the home, in the church, or in the hall, in the lectern, in whatever name you call it, just stand up or you sit down and speak to people. That's the way God has chosen. And the Bible says, for the preaching of the cross, so then that perish is foolishness. Of course, not everybody will receive it. But unto us which are saved, it is the power of God. God has decided to demonstrate his power, the power of his word, his saving power, his healing power, his deliverance power through the word. And if you read Psalm 107, verse 20, he said he gave the word. God gave the word. And great was the company of those who published it. Okay, he said he sent his word. And he healed them and delivered them from their destruction. He sent the word. That is God sending the word. Also the preacher sending the word into the congregation. That's why the place of preaching cannot be mortgaged in the service. I'm very sorry for church services that there is no time for the preaching. There's no time to disseminate the word. There's no time to communicate the word. There's no time to speak to people from the very word of God. I'm very sorry. We have allowed dancing and singing and worship or whatever, or singing whatever, or contribution to replace the, or prophecy to replace the place of preaching. Churches like that will never grow. The broom we can give to God, so to say, in illustrative way, the broom we can give to the Holy Spirit to clean people's life, to vacuum their life for sicknesses and diseases and calamities and sin, is a preaching. The preaching is a broom, is a vacuum cleaner that will give to Holy Spirit, help me clean the life of this my audience. How do we do it? So if there is no preaching, the church will never grow. The church will never develop. The church will never become what Jesus wants the church to be. We must preach. I must preach in a very logical, earnest way, clear way, sincere way, relevant way. And going to Bible school does not guarantee that you become a good preacher. Rather, to preach effectively for growth is to be guided by the following, because not all preaching will bring growth to the church. Spiritual growth, transformational growth, numerical growth, all kinds of growth, financial growth, is not every preaching. There are a lot of preaching that kill the growth of churches. There are a lot of preaching that sedate the growth of churches. There are a lot of preaching that stagnates churches. So how do you do the preaching that will bring growth to church? Number one, pray and get your message from God. Message from God, not sermons. Sermons are from men. Messages are from God. When your people know that they respect you, that your preaching is going to be messages from the Lord to their heart, to their life, to their situation, they're going to listen, and that you will only get message from God when you really pray. Not that you go and copy messages from other churches, which a lot of us are doing today. We are experts in doing today. That's why the power is not there. Two, study and understand the subject very well. Any subject you don't understand, don't preach it. It's better not to preach it than to preach around nonsense or be preaching errors to your people. Preaching makes people. It can make them, it can determine their heaven, and it will determine their heaven. It will determine how they live. Three, ask the Holy Spirit to breathe upon the message if you have received it from the Lord. Pray on your knees. Pray on your knees before you come out. Pray very well. Don't just stand up and say anything and open your mouth. No, you must pray very well. Four, write out your message in a jotter or an outline. Yeah, follow an outline. Don't be a extemporaneous preacher. You are just preaching from one end to end. Just say, and at the end of the day, somebody asks you, audience, what did the preacher say? They say, he talked to the Lord. What did they say? I don't really understand. I don't get it. It was just rambling. That's a rambling preacher. It doesn't grow churches. It doesn't transform people's lives. Then, be simple, be clear, and be logical in your delivery. Don't be somebody that was speaking big time grammar that people would need a dictionary to interpret your words, or you want to display that you have a grasp of the language. No, preach in a simple, logical, relevant way. Then always dwell on a subject at a time. Avoid rambling. Then use illustrations. Sometimes you use jokes, sometimes you use stories and examples in between. It will bring your message home. Relevant one, do. Preach practical and straightforward messages. Messages that touches people's life. Messages that touch people where they are hurting. That hit them. Messages that are direct. Don't just be rambling just going about. You can't go to the right point. No, go directly. Avoid the grammar you don't know. Sometimes make your message a series on various aspects and issues. Don't throw away your outline because you might be throwing away part of tomorrow. Keep your outline, because there's a principle in preaching that says that you don't really understand the message until you preach it about 7 times. Not all preachings or teachings will result in growth. In fact, some preaching will kill more than nothing else. Leaders that desire growth must always preach nothing up but Jesus and nothing down but the devil. Preach Jesus up. If you are going to preach anything down, it's the devil. As you preach, as you learn to preach for growth, because it's a learning process. That's one of the ways to see growth in your church. The Lord will bless you. From your pulpit, you can bring a lot of transformations. And from your pulpit, you can be a lot of stagnation and destruction. But I pray you learn the grace to bring transformations through your preachings. In Jesus' name. Hello out there. I am Francis Bola Akijo, a church consultant of 25 years standing. You can invite me to your local churches, your denomination, your pastoral conferences, for consultation, for consultancy, for seminars, teachings and training on healthy local churches, so that our churches can grow across Africa. The Lord bless you. I await your invitation. Amen.